couple of years ago in the vision survey that we all participated in, we all agreed and noted in the survey response that the parking lot is a top item that needs to be addressed. And I'm pleased that we're finally going to be doing something with that. You know, the bottom line is that the condition of the parking lot is unsafe. And it's a deterrent for those who come to look at our church hall as a potential venue for their event. They come in and they look at the condition of the parking lot and they say, if the parking lot looks like this, we don't even want to look at the hall. So we know, collectively, we need to do something to address this. And I'm pleased that we're finally motivated and have the ambition to move forward and get it done. So in May of 2016, at a General Assembly meeting that some of you may have attended, Parish Council John Trehaus presented an update with regard to our opportunity to do something about the parking lot. And at that time, we, General Assembly, gave approval to Parish Council to create two committees, a Construction Oversight Committee and a Capital Campaign Committee, and in order to go off and make this thing happen. So the Construction Committee, which is headed by Arthur Karras and Michael Pearl, worked very closely with an engineer, A.M. Pigley, to take a close look at what's going on with this parking lot and what do we need to do. What they did was they came up with three sections of the parking lot that we need to address kind of in order. And if we have the ability to do all three, we will, but our sights are being set on the first of those areas for replacement. Quickly, those areas are the back gravel lot, which is really only used when we have our church festival for overflow parking. The second part is all the way in the back by the soccer fields. Again, it's only used when we have large groups here. But the first and most important need is that area of the parking lot that surrounds the church that we all use every week or sometimes every day. That's the focus of our capital campaign. Now, with the help of Ann Higley, they came up with an estimate. This is an estimate. We're going to confirm it after we get bids from contractors to do the work. But the estimate is that it's going to cost us $750,000 to replace that section of the parking lot. Thank you, Alex. So the fundraising committee that Thalia and I work on has been working for months to try to figure out how we're going to raise $750,000. Pretty daunting task. As Father mentioned, we're calling this campaign Pave the Way. And what we need to do is get a pledge commitment from all of you to get to $750,000 by the end of March of this year. And then the financial payment of that commitment by July of this year. Because our plans are to replace that first section of the parking lot right after the festival ends and have it done just before the preschool starts. So a very short window we have to do a major construction project. So that's the overview of our objective, $750,000, and our timing. And now, Thalia, why don't you share a few words?
Thank you, Chris. And also, I wanted to thank Father, Nicholas, the altar boys, the choir, parish council, Elaine, and all of you ministries, parishioners of St. Paul that have worked so hard throughout these 50 years. Some of you have been here right from the very beginning. Some of you have come in the middle, and some of you are new, but we want you to know that we appreciate and are very grateful for all the hard work that you do for our church. As a proud daughter of one of St. Paul's founding fathers, John Emanuel, and his wife Catherine, I have been blessed to be a part of this community since its inception. Throughout these past 50 years, I have served St. Paul to the best of my ability and have worked alongside many of you. It's been such an honor and a lot of fun to work with so many great-hearted and talented stewards of St. Paul. And it is an honor to be a part of our Pave the Way committee and working alongside Chris. Many years ago, when describing the history of St. Paul, our dear and a founding charter member, Mike Spikas, wrote, and I quote, "A dream that began humbly in 1963 in the minds of a few and grew to become the driving purpose of an entire community is today a proud, thrilling reality," end of quote. We begin this new year with our wonderful community continuing to be a proud, thrilling reality of that long ago dream. Such an everlasting testament to our former and current parishioners, and in loving memory to all those parishioners who are now with the Lord. We steadfastly continue to grow together and thrive. Today is January 8, 2017. And on January 12, 1964, almost 53 years ago to the day, a historic First Assembly meeting was called. The Assembly on that day decided to create a permanent committee that would work for the establishment of a Greek Orthodox church for the residents of the Southwest area community. 34 families were present at that assembly, and a new colony known as the Parma Area Hellenic Orthodox Parish was formed. The colony struggled but continued to grow. By March 1964, over $4,000 had been pledged, and by November of the same year, the pledges, along with donations from the Ladies Auxiliary, as the Ladies Voluptuous was known in the beginning, had swelled to $24,000. As you can see, the hardworking ethos and determination of this community has been present from day one. When our church was built, the paving company owned by Jim Alex, a founding father of St. Paul, and his brother Pete Alex, a founding charter member, generously donated our current and original parking lot, just so you know. Throughout the years, our beloved Michael Alex, son of Jim and Angie Alex, lovingly looked over and maintained our parking lot. I honestly believe that the reason our lot lasted this long was due in no small part to Michael's dedication. With the realization that the lot could no longer be repaired, Michael relentlessly pursued his dream of replacing it. Such a seemingly insurmountable task would not deter the ever optimistic Michael. Upon Michael's untimely death, which not only devastated his family, but tore at the hearts of this community, an extraordinary outpouring of contributions were made in his memory. As a tribute to this exceptional man and devoted servant of God, Michael's family directed the donations be put towards a new parking lot. By the grace of God, the $50,000 raised by Michael's memorial, and now referred to as Michael's gift, was matched by a most generous St. Paul donor who wishes to remain anonymous. In the past few months, we've had additional donors step forward to join Pave the Way campaign and are very pleased to report that we have raised $330,000 toward our $750,000 $1 goal. We are also extremely thankful and grateful for having received 100% participation from our Parish Council and Capital Campaign Committee. We are deeply touched and humbled by the generosity we've seen so far and want to publicly thank the 50 families, individuals, who graciously and generously donated. A very big and heartfelt thank you.
Thanks, Thalia, and thank you from me as well. I know I've talked to a number of you who stepped forward and donated already and offered my thanks, and to those who I haven't, thank you. We've made tremendous progress between 750,000 now at 330,000. So what's the difference between 750,000 and 330,000?
420.
An accountant will tell you 420, but what I'll tell you the difference is you. We're coming to you today, our dedicated St. Paul parishioners, to ask for your support over this campaign. This week, we're going to be doing a mailing. A package is going to come to you, and the contents of the package will include more information about this campaign. There will be a brochure in the package that will explain to you a little bit more detail about how we're going to proceed through the fundraising and construction efforts, the timing, and so forth. We've also anticipated a lot of the questions already. We have a number of frequently asked questions and our answers to those questions in the brochure. Also included will be a donation form and a return envelope so that we can get all of you to participate in this important effort. As Thalia mentioned, we had 50 people already step forward and donate a total of $330,000. And my thought is this: if 50 people can raise 330, what can the remainder of us do? There are 450 family units here at St. Paul, and if each of us donated $1,000 each, we would be able to achieve our goal. Now, I know $1,000 may be more than some folks can afford, and that makes it the responsibility of the rest of us who have been blessed with more, who have more to give and offer, to contribute more than $1,000. But net, we need about, on average, $1,000 per family here in St. Paul. As you consider giving, think back to those who founded this church and all of the sacrifice and effort that they made in order to build this beautiful church. You know, it's our turn now to pay for what needs to be paid for in order to maintain this church for our safety and for our convenience. For me personally, I have two sons here at St. Paul. You may know them, Nicholas and Alexander. And like probably the founding fathers of this church, who wanted to create something for their generations to come, I feel it's my obligation to offer support in order for this church to be there for my children and their children. And with that, Thalia?
So please, help us pave the way towards a new parking lot. Together, we can.
Thank you, everyone.